And we are back.
Hello again, everyone.
Hello.
Hi, guys. It's been a long time. Oh, Eli and Franz, you're here.
Yes, we are.
How'd you guys get back here so fast?
You can't get rid of us that easily.
Oh, God. Oh, man. So here we are with Salmon Souls, as per requested.
Salmon Souls. Really?
Well, the...
Salmon.
The box art's kind of a salmon-y color, so salmon souls, why not?
Are we
that
at,
kind of thing.
Really, are we at that part of the night now?
We literally just started, so well, I mean,
morning
I guess
for,
so.
We just started after something like 8.5 hours of bacon, man, though. Let's date this right now. This is about half an hour on the heels of the end of the Bacon Man stream.
God, it is, man. That's the crazy part.
It is.
How did we do? Dude, honestly, like, it's kind of a blur, like, looking back at it now. Like, I barely even remember all of it.
Well, you'll remember soon enough.
Yeah, when I go through to edit it, which, thankfully, I don't have to do much. I just need to cut it and then export. God. So I'm thinking, I know Eli's thinking a Dex build, right?
Kind of.
I think that's kind of what I'm going for, too. So, either, like, Dex, magic-y kind of thing, I guess.
My first character's name is Plague. This one's name will also be Plague.
Plague again.
Awesome. Aren't you glad you only have 4 slots for characters in this game?
Oh, look, Franz, it says Johannes, a Finnish spy, is back.
Oh, God. Well, I'm just glad that there are only 4 character slots, because that way we won't get all 10 Plagues.
Oh man, what's the most weeaboo name I could come up with for this character?
Something incorrectly written in Romanji.
Oh, like God. Okay, we'll wait on chat because I'm sure chat will have some wonderful weeaboo names for us.
You can completely skip the tutorial. I didn't know that.
Once you've done it once on one character, you can. Yes.
This starts. You died.
Yep.
That's pretty awesome, dude. I love Demon Souls, man.
I do too.
Okay. So I just need to rush through this first area and beat Phalanx, I guess.
Yeah, you can just speed run it. And I mean, if you want to go lure the Red Eye Knight off the battlements a couple of times for some souls for fire bombs, that works too.
Okay, I just need to remember how to get there. I need to unlock. I need to get to the Dragon Bridge, right?
Yeah, that's and to get there, head up to the top of the steps and turn left.
Oh God, so many names. Jesus Christ. Let's see, we've got Franzu Senpai, and just name her Gatsu because literally only weebs stand by that version of his name.
Well,
oh my God.
It's hard to argue with that.
To answer the my question of which Souls Blood game is the longest overall, not counting cheap skips. Spunk, it really depends on what you make it, man. Any Souls game could be the longest one. It depends on how much effort you're willing to put it. Suzuki Hayabusa. Jesus Christ, that one's perfect.
Oh, God. I don't know if you can fit that, though.
I don't think I could, but Suzuki will definitely be one. That is definitely a weeb.
Oh, you're still in character creation?
Yeah. Still.
Okay, good. See, it's going to be a little bit of time.
Oh, yeah.
Well, we were joking about this, that, like, you might be the one that ended up in character creation the longest. Look, my ass is still 10 million feet behind.
I'm probably just going to delete this character later, just because I need to have everything perfect.
I am completely with you on that, Eli.
This kind of looked like me, though. A more rugged, handsome version of me.
Why is she fucking... Why are her eyes like that? Oh, God.
Well, you're making a Japanese character, no, Nick? Why are her eyes like that? You're freaking racist.
I was complaining to Franz about this last night. How it's so hard in the Souls games to get something that has a chin. Yeah. Like, if the chin wants to
blend directly
into the neck.
That is absolutely true. You're definitely right. Why is that so difficult?
Face gen, that's why. Actually, I don't remember if these games even use face gen. I think face gen was what they used in Fallout, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Alright, so I'm doing royalty female. Do you contest to this, Franz?
I do not.
All right. Wait, was royalty the one with the that started with the
rapier and with and, soul arrow?
Okay, yeah, I was making sure it started with soul arrow.
I started as a magician.
Magician?
Soul arrow.
Yeah, dexterity and magic.
Oh, okay. You're going for a mage build, Eli?
it instructed me that this would be the best way to go.
Ah.
As far as Mugen Monkey goes, which could be completely wrong.
Well, no, Mugen Monkey is pretty decent most of the time, so...
It's kind of hard to take that site seriously.
What, Mugen Monkey? Yeah.
Thank you, Lipton Franz the Penis, for donating.
What? Oh, God.
Lipton Franz the Penis. Like, I like how it used to be kind of, like, pseudo-clever, then it was just ridiculous. Now it's just, like, penis.
Just go like, right there. Don't cut out the middleman. Just cut straight to the chase. So the world might
be mended. Penis butt Ugh. Deer spank.
Nothing like a quick deer spank to get the blood flowing.
Hell yeah.
Chosen undead, you are the blood. Chosen undead, welcome to the Nexus.
Quiet you.
That's how it works, right?
Get my ass.
Alright. Stockpile Thomas, love you, you're the best. I guess we're getting straight into the game. Like, are we wasting time with anything?
Oh, I mean, wasting time is all a matter of opinion. I don't know that you're wasting time.
That's true.
Whoa.
Oh, Strunson, that was nothing, dude. We almost hit 400 earlier. Which was amazing.
Oh, you
gave me the warm Ghiblis. All thanks to Eli and Franz over here.
Oh,
we're
nice.
Actually one. We are
I'm
one of three
another
streams.
Tweet later once we actually get rid of Phalanx.
Okay.
Once we start the co-op proper.
Sounds good.
That. Was that a glitch in the audio or was that a belch?
You can't even tell.
Like, I couldn't actually tell if it was a glitch or a belch. Dude, oh god. After all that Dark Souls and then just coming straight to demons, I feel like I've run the gamut lately, dude. Because, like, I was doing, like, all this Bloodborne, then did some Witcher, and then fucking back to Dark Souls. Now I'm in Demon Souls. I don't even know what I'm doing anymore.
You can't escape it. Whenever you think you're out, the Souls series sucks you back in.
No, dude, Demons just, like, I love the vibe I get. Like, I just love the music in Demons, and it's got a great aesthetic to it.
Stuff too. Like, I'm just coming into Demons. I'm coming into Demons.
I see what you did.
Things just like the FX and stuff like that has its own distinct feel.
It does, yeah.
Yeah,
like, I could just listen to the character create music forever, too.
The sound design for this game was excellent. The Foley was pretty damn solid, and especially the soundtrack. Shunsuke Kida is the one who did the soundtrack for this game.
Yeah, he's awesome.
Yeah, he's very, very talented guy.
I thought they'd bring him back for Bloodborne, but I was a bit disappointed to see that they didn't.
They didn't, but what was his name? Ryan Ammon, whom they got for Bloodborne. He did a damn good job, too.
He really did do a great job. I'm just saying, I'm surprised, since it's such a spiritual successor to Demons, they weren't like, oh, let's just get the same fucking guy.
Well,
but Sakuraba did very well with Dark Souls 2. Like, it actually had some great tracks.
And he did Dark Souls 1's OST as well, didn't he, Sakuraba?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He did well with Dark Souls 2 as well. So, I mean, relative, I guess.
It was really strange to me when I first heard that Motoi Sakuraba had done the soundtrack for Dark Souls 1 and 2, because I will never be able to picture his music as anything other than, like, the soundtracks from Valkyrie Profile and Star Ocean that are really, really synthesizer-heavy and just have a completely different sound than the Souls. Like, Souls is very orchestral, whereas Valkyrie Profile and Star Ocean are synthesized to the max, and, like, those were fantastic soundtracks as well. They really capitalized on the synthesized aspects of that, but completely, vastly different styles from the same guy. It's amazing what Sakuraba is capable of in terms of variety.
Well, Shimamoto is the exact same way. Like, I mean, even like Legend of Mana and Kingdom Hearts, while they do share, let me ban this.
Those are a lot closer, though. Like, Yoko Shimamoto's music. The Kingdom Hearts soundtrack is a lot more similar, I think, to the Legend of Mana soundtrack than the old Enix games were to Souls, you know?
Sorry, I got distracted. I had to ban somebody in chat.
That's fine.
So I know I just said something about Shimamoto and, like, how even Legend of Mana and Kingdom Hearts, while sounding similar, sound totally different, like, in terms of their presentation. And I guess you had a response to that, and I totally missed it. Sorry.
Oh, it was just that those are a lot more similar to each other than the Star Ocean or Valkyrie Profile games and Souls soundtracks. And Nick, yeah. Did you say you were going to use a rapier?
Yeah, I am. I guess I will, yeah.
Okay.
Dude, oh god, it feels so good to play like a fast character after doing so much Bacon Man to me. Like, it's just like...
Whenever we were talking about demons, I knew it was like, he's gonna love coming back to this.
Yeah. Oh my god, I feel so much speedier. I'm just like, oh, thank god.
I don't know if it's just the Bacon Man build that did that, but... Is it just me, or do the rest of you feel this way as well, that playing the later Souls games just makes coming back to demons that much more satisfying?
It does. There's a lot that they got right. I mean, like, Dark Souls is still my favorite, but, I mean, that doesn't mean by any stretch that I don't like the other ones. Well, Dark Souls 2, but we've beaten that to death tonight, so I'm just going to shut up about it.
Okay.
Like, I can't say any more about Dark... I mean, I could, but I don't think anybody wants to hear it. By the way... We are one of three Demon Souls streams, and I feel real bad because the other two have like one viewer.
Well,
like I see that, and like I understand, like, you know, just starting out a channel, and it can be really, really hard. And I want to like support, but the problem is like so many people are doing this now, and they just don't put any effort in. You go in there, and you're just like, oh my god, what's happening here?
Sitting there playing that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, they've got like this like awful green screen face cam, and their mic sounds like it was in a dumpster, and like.
They're recording in a dumpster. They just live there.
But that's not like that has nothing to do with the other streamers. I haven't even seen them, but I can understand why people sometimes are reluctant to try new stuff.
Yeah, and we're kind of lucky in some ways that Peeve isn't streaming Demon Souls tonight, because if he was, we'd be the second stream of Demon Souls.
We'd be just dead last. Like, we just can't compete with the power that is Peeve's stream.
Well, I mean, whenever he streams Demon's Souls, he ends up with, like, about 1,000 viewers or more. Like, the time that I ended up as his old monk boss and we just had a fist fight, that was the best. But that time, I think he had around 1,600 people.
He's a great player, dude. He deserves it. Like,
well, he has his moments. I think during that entire fight, I parried him 3 or 4 times, and I actually managed to parry his headbutt, which I didn't even know was possible.
I didn't know. Oh yeah, you were telling me about that, and I think in our Demon Souls playthrough, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we finally were able to pick it back up.
Yeah,
but...
Peeve's awesome. It's really a shame he couldn't make it tonight, but I mean, especially considering that now here we are playing Demon Souls, but he had to go out and buy a computer desk.
It's been quite a while since I've seen any Peeve stuff. I know I have in the past, but it's been a while.
Well, he doesn't upload to YouTube very often. He almost exclusively streams on Twitch these days, and what he does upload to YouTube tends to be stream highlights.
Now I've got to remember how the... Oh, right, the Blue Knight fog door. I was trying to remember how I even got there in the first place.
Oh, yep.
How do I do?
Yeah, that fog door past the Blue Eye Knight just leads to everything
you need
to do.
It's a good thing we're starting new characters, because there's no way that... I mean, if we're going to a completely new area, I guess, but being able to run through this area now that I know it fairly well is much better.
It's much amazing better. How much difference that makes, isn't it?
Very much. Also, the first time I went through this thing, I was completely lost.
Just to address the chat real quick, I'm going to do my best to keep track of everything. Like, what am I doing? I literally just rolled into the Red Eye Knight and just got obliterated. What am I doing? Like, this is what happens when you play Souls for like 8 hours straight. But I just wanted to clarify earlier what I meant when I was talking about the other things. That wasn't like saying anybody was bad. I'm just saying like I understand people's reluctancy to try new things, because sometimes, like, you know, you just run into so much bad that you're just like, I just can't give anything else a shot. And like, and I know that feeling, like, especially with like music and stuff lately. I'm kind of like that now too, where I'm just like, it's an artist in this genre, it's gonna suck. Like, I'm just like giving up. I'm like, fuck.
I find myself just listening to video game music all the time now. I just can't listen to anything else, because
it's pretty easy to do, man. There's a lot of great stuff out there.
Yeah,
especially as you get older, it can be music or movies or whatever. You do kind of get into this rut of, I know this is good, and I do not have the energy to fight all this new stuff just to try to figure out what, you know, I actually can tolerate.
So yeah, definitely.
The same thing over and over again.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. The getting old rut.
We're all there, aren't we? We all know how that. Well, not you, Nick. You're young.
Oh my God! Stop it. You do this every time. You're like, you're so much younger. I'm like, you're like 2 years older than me.
Does Strava leave unless you go down there and visit him?
Well, what happens is that what you're meant to do, and this is kind of dumb in some ways, but. when you beat Phalanx and then advance to the next area on the way to the Tower Knight, Ostrava will move to that area to a spot where he's actually safe.
Well, I was just wondering if I could run past this, although I kind of would like to get the beast ring.
Well, if you run past it without talking to Ostrava, then he'll just stay there and never move forward.
Good, good, because he got his dumbass killed on my other build.
Right.
How did he get killed, dude? Eli.
This was a great story. Well, I laughed at this.
He didn't really kill himself so much as I brutally murdered him.
Why?
You didn't murder
him. Because I rescued him.
I thought you said...
I rescued him in, like, true Dark Souls fashion. I thought, I got that part done. And I rezoned because I was trying to get some of the shit from under the dragons, right?
Right, right.
And, I didn't realize that he was still there. And in addition to still being there, since you talk to him once, he just drops down and kills all the enemies and keeps going about his business like he would if he was routing after you clear the area for him.
He wanders around, yeah.
And I was strolling through, and then I looked down and saw a health bar dropping. I was like, oh, fuck. So I had to run down there, and I saw he had like 10 health left or something. And I turned a corner, and I saw like one guy dropping to his knees, like, oh shit. So I just swung, and it turned out he had just got through killing an enemy, and I beheaded him with one swift motion.
Oh, poor Ostrava. You murdered him in cold blood.
You know what? That freaking idiot had it coming. I was sick of his whining.
I was sick of his whining.
Help! Help! I got myself trapped in a bunch of demons for no good reason. Help!
Soul Arrow is so broken early on.
All the magic and demons. Granted, when they added the dark magic in Dark Souls 1, that was unequivocally more broken. But, like, Firestorm in hyper mode in Demon Souls, it didn't get much more broken than that until dark magic in Dark Souls 1.
So, Plague, how did you end up handling your Red Eye Knight problem?
I have actually never been hit by him before, so I don't know how strong he is. But
off the edge. Yeah, I was going to say, do you just... Because I ran back, like, I wait, and I'll keep the Blue Eye Knight up and the Red Eye Knight, and I'll just kite them both back and just let them fly off the edge.
It does take quite a while to farm him using that method, I noticed.
It does, yeah. But, I mean, the thing that's nice, I guess, about having Soul Arrows, you could just nail the Blue Eye Knight and that one-shots him, and then you could just kite the other dude back and just let him fall off.
I just parry the Blue Eyes just because he's so fucking easy. He's basically...
He is.
Try that with the Red Eye Knight, see how long it lasts.
Well,
with that damn spear, dude. And he just...
I knew from Dark Souls experience that pairing spears is no joke.
Oh yeah, nope, not at all. And it's worse with the Red Eye Knights in particular because they don't follow the player model animations. They have their own rig and their own attacks. And their forward thrusting spear attack that looks like it should hit you all of once will actually hit 7 or 8 times for enormous damage each hit. And it's instant death. And it'll stun lock the shit out of you so you can't get away from it.
Sort of like the Pike or the Estoc running attack?
Yeah, very similar. Except, like, 4 of those in one attack.
Oh, the climbing in Demon Souls is so silly.
Yeah.
I really like that, though. I mean, not really a working system, exactly. But I like being able to jump over shit.
Yeah.
Ostrava, you should totally help me fight these guys. So I'll just backstab you off.
Just like everybody else does.
I mean, I love Ostrava, but I'm not past doing that to him.
He's not, like, completely capable. He's not like he's just some weakling or something, exactly.
No, but he is a moron.
Yeah.
Well, he's a pampered son. He's a pampered son with, like, fancy armor.
Fair enough. Yeah, I guess...
Release the balls.
I'd give an arm just for the buttons off his shirt.
He really is cool, though. Like, I like Ostrava. It's a tragic ending for him too.
Yeah.
It's like, well, that's sad.
Wouldn't have it any other way. Miyazaki doesn't like happy endings because fuck that, it's Japan.
No, there he likes happy endings. Remember he's got the slug ending.
What?
Oh, chosen slug undead.
Are you cold?
Come on, people.
Oh right, that's
Oh, good ending. Hunter slug, you're my favorite chosen undead. This soul binds you to the Nexus, great one. Oh, man. Oh, the Scimitar.
I have to say, I think that the obligatory use all souls to warp back to X area makes the most sense in Demon Souls because it's a leg shackle.
Yeah, that's true.
And when they say, it binds you to the Nexus, they mean that literally, like you're shackled to the Nexus.
Well, the dark sign binds you to undeath, I mean.
Mm. Because it's like, you know, if I'm there, I'm going to try. I think it's
Void, I'm not forgetting about Chad, I'm sorry.
I think it's more made if you run out of resources, like I don't have enough to heal or something, then you'll do it, but...
Well, yeah, and if you have no souls or only a small amount of souls and you just need to get out quickly...
Get your ass here, that's true. Lazy, coward-ass dragon.
That's like my least favorite part of this zone, having to go through and grab that, because... You know, I say this, that inadvertently I fail every time, and I don't think I've failed on camera yet, which means I just jinxed the shit out of myself.
Oh yeah, you're going down now, Nick.
I'm dead, it's over, like, that's it.
Come on, you fat idiot.
Rip in peace. How did I miss that every fucking time?
There we go.
Is the dragon working now, Eli?
Yes, the big dumb moron.
What's the item down there by the exploding barrels? I can't remember.
Where, Nick? In the stairwell?
With, like, all the draglings.
It's some grass, I think.
Oh. I guess we'll get it.
If you mean the one in the hallway, it's the Kling Ring, after you pull the lever to open the gate.
No, not the one in the hallway. Whatever the fuck it's called. It's a bunch of exploding barrels, lots of draglings. It's in, like, an open air. It's kind of off to the side where the Blue Eye Knight with the claymore is.
Oh. Yeah, I think it's just some grass. It's nothing important, I remember that much.
Well, we've gone through it now, so feck it.
Now I'm having the opposite problem. You won't go away.
when it rains, it pours, huh? Feast or famine.
Get out of here, you big dumb moron.
What you've got to do, Eli, is wait right until he starts roasting the bridge. And when he starts roasting the bridge, run back over and grab all his stuff.
Well, I'm not going to do that yet. I'm just trying to rush through.
It's actually the tail slam that kills me the most because I'm just terrible at the timing.
Oh, from the
reason.
Blue dragon, you mean? When you're
yeah, that's what kills me. It's not the other shit. Like I always just I'm like doo-ba-doo, ah.
Well, the trick, Nick, is that you've got to bait the tail slam and then run in and grab stuff afterward.
Oh, I know the trick. I'm just a failure at it. Trust me, man. I know the mechanic. I'm just bad.
It helps to be able to acknowledge your shortcomings.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not gonna pretend like the best Souls player ever. There are tons of people out there better than me.
Well, not these me anymore, guys. Apparently.
I keep trying to use a jump attack with these spear guys. And it's like, yeah, there isn't one.
Nope. Yeah, I know, right?
Oh, plague, a fellow jump attack lover.
It's so useful.
People who are, it's so good. I love the jump attack. Some people are just all anti-jump attack.
Oh, it's unbelievable. Like, the crazy thing about the jump attack is it's even better in Bloodborne because they went back to a system of no poise, just super armor. And jump attacks for really heavy weapons like the Kirkhammer are basically instant super armor break on nearly any enemy. There are bosses in the dungeons in particular, like the Keeper of the Old Lords, which is basically a Dark Wraith with a katana, which... if you use the jump attack on them as they're approaching you from outside their range, their AI literally does not know what to do and cannot handle it, and you can just spam jump attacks the whole battle and there's nothing they can do.
Oh, man. What was that one fight in Dark Souls 2 that people were speculating was like the Chosen Undead Reborn? Was that the... God, what the hell fight was that? It's the big white... The big white and black creature that was in the Abyss.
Oh, the Dark Lurker.
Yeah, Dark Lurker. Oh, it's totally Chosen Undead Reborn. I'm like, dear Jesus.
No, shut up.
Like that. I'm like, we are literally just coming up with shit at this point.
Well, that's...
Like fanfic frenzy, baby.
Why do you think we don't make Dark Souls 2 lore videos?
Well, I tried at one point.
A lot of people treat the Souls games.
Wow.
Like, it's based on your personal lore, and they take that to mean that just make up shit. For no good reason.
I tried a while back just by presenting the facts that were available in the game, and like I ultimately came to no conclusion. I was like, yeah, just, you know, here you go. Like those are some other videos that I'm either debating on just completely taking down or just putting a big ass disclaimer that was like, these videos were made when I thought there was lore to this game. Pro tip, there's not.
Yeah. Well, the last time when I described my approach to evaluating the Soul series lore to you, Eli, what was it you said? Oh, Mr. Scientist.
Oh, yeah, I was saying explaining something. I was trying to explain something. I can't remember what. And I was offering up like several explanations of what things could potentially be. And you said something like, "Well, I only take what information the game gives me." And I was like, "Oh, excuse me, Mr. Soul Scientist."
Right.
Only
right.
Going by the facts.
Oh my god.
I think that was when we were talking about the effigy shield in Dark Souls 1. And we were kind of batting back and forth how, I was going over the explicit evidence that was provided through item descriptions and dialogue, and you were talking about some more abstract theories that involved kind of extrapolating stuff that was in the game based on conjecture, and you really let me have it over that.
I love the word extrapolate.
Fair to myself, I was not making shit up so much as I was saying, well, here's the information that we have, which could potentially mean these things.
Oh, no, I know. That's why I described it the way I did, rather than just saying you were making shit up. Like, you were legitimately extrapolating it from fairly credible sources. But, like, it was just, you know, that where that discussion went was amusing to me.
Oh, Franz, I died at the dragon, by the way.
I saw that.
I told you.
I told you to wait and bait out the tail attack, man. You didn't wait.
Bro,
you just
I did bait it. I didn't dodge at the right time.
You waited for it and you rolled face first into it, Nick.
Bro, you can roll into stuff just because I mistimed it. You could roll whatever direction you want in the Souls game.
You
can
roll into stuff, but some of it'll kill you. You could roll into those fires right there if you want.
I'll roll into it. Just watch me. You don't control my
He'll
life.
Do it just to spite me. He'll now jump into one of these fires just to spite me.
I have not used this flame toss yet.
It's pretty damn good.
Yeah, the way
I've been cheesing the shit out of Soul Arrow.
He was like, "Shit, you better get this."
Yeah,
you better get this shit, you dumb dumb. Oh my god, I should have opened up the damn shortcut before I did all this garbage.
I was gonna say you didn't open up the shortcut first.
No, I let the dragon clear the damn bridge, and then I was like, "Yeah, I've got it." Dude, every time I'm lazy in the Souls series, dude, this game just bites me in the fucking ass.
But that's the beauty of the Souls games.
I'm with you, man. I get it.
Like, even after having played these Demon Souls specifically, I've got, at this point, probably over 4,000 hours. In fact, unequivocally over 4,000 hours in Demon Souls ever since 2009. Like, this game still punishes me for thinking, oh yeah, I'm super MLG pro. I can just speed run this area. And then an enemy that I forgot was there just jumps out of the shadows and kills me in one hit.
Oh, of course. Every fucking time. I do love it though, man.
But that's
I love
like,
these games.
The Souls games are the gift that keeps on giving. No joke whatsoever, they really are.
I love the fact that they're so replayable. Both
yeah.
Bloodborne.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, apart from Bloodborne. Hopefully that expansion will add some content to the game that will actually improve replayability, because I have major problems about that game's lack of replayability.
You know, that clinic skip was a godsend.
Yeah, and
it really was. Yeah,
I loved
the clinic skip.
Because
it was awesome.
It opens up, like, I could immediately go for certain weapons, finally. Whereas if you have to do it normally, it's like, well, no, you have to do this very specific series of things.
Mm. Yeah, Eli, I'm right there with you, dude. I think actually Franz and I were talking about that. Why did I just do that?
We were.
I think we were talking about that the other day, about how, like, I wish they had kept the clinic skip, because it basically added in that kind of, like, Dark Souls flair. You know, like the Berg skip, where you can jump down to Capra. Mm. Yeah, that kind of like feeling of, well, I can just skip all this shit and go get my, you know, key to the depths and or key to Blighttown and all this other crap and blah, blah, blah. But yeah, I was a bit bummed when they did patch that, like, deliberately and very quickly, too.
I'm surprised that they went out of their way to patch it, because they've never, ever patched a skip before.
Yeah, it was a bit disappointing, but I mean, it's a bug. I mean, I get it, but
I wonder if it has to do with the fact that the clinic skip was found as early in the game's life as it was, because things like the archive skip in Dark Souls 1, by the time anyone figured that out, the game was well past its prime and no longer being patched.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what it was. It was because the game is designed in such a way that if you do a skip like that, it changes the kind of day-night system, whatever you want to call it. It actually breaks some elements of the game.
Yeah, I guess.
So they kind
of does.
But I think also it might have had to do with the fact that Sony was so butthurt when somebody jumped over one of the fences in Central Yharnam during the network test and got to the Father Gascoigne fight and saw all of the incomplete environmental textures and zones. They were really mad about that, to the extent that they went out of their way to DMCA a bunch of those videos.
Holy shit. Well, I mean, it is a lot of negative publicity if you get to see an unfinished game, because people start judging it based off that. And I mean, I understand, like, the reluctance for people to see that, but there's also no need to be, like, they should be like, well, if you saw it, just keep in mind that this content is, you know, in development. So
yeah, no,
I don't know
why they get so bent out of shape over that when obviously the game's not done. What do you expect from it? And Nick, is it just me, or did you actually get a weapon drop from that Blue Eye Knight, or was that a throwing dagger?
No way, dude. There's no way that dropped.
Phalanx is dead, by the way.
Wow, Eli, you really did speed run the area.
He mowed it down, dude. If I hadn't been an idiot, we might have been there by now.
And I didn't do anything with the dragons.
Well, that's okay. I think we might have a way of dealing with that, actually.
Do I not have any more? God damn it, I don't have any more crescent. I hate when I run out of crescent grass.
Well, at least you can carry 99 crescent grass, and 99 half moon grass, and 99 full moon grass, and 99 late moon grass, and 99 dark moon grass.
So what you're saying is I can carry some grass.
Carry 600.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if I actually... Do I care about the Ring of Great Strength? I feel like I don't with this playthrough.
Well, if you're going to go Dex, you're going to be a light character anyway. Eli, what?
Yeah,
I said I have to go talk to the Monumental, apparently, before
You can just mash through all that, though, Eli. You've seen it already.
Yeah, go talk to little bald kid with the candles. Go talk to fucking Caillou up there.
Caillou? God. Eli, when you're done down there, stay in body form and head to the Phalanx Arch Stone. I'll put my sign down.
Oh, that's right. We have to stay in that, don't we?
Yeah, in body form. But that's fine.
Do you have to be in body form in order for someone to, in order for you to invade someone?
You can't be in body form.
I know it has your health already.
Yeah, you have to be in soul form.
You have to be in soul form to invade in this game, and you have to be in body form to be invaded.
Okay.
But I'm going to, once you come and meet up with me, Eli, I'm going to give you a few of the item that lets you get back to body form.
Ah, the Stone of Ephemeral Eyes. Yep. Dude, this is bringing back memories, Franz, like, big time.
Is it?
Yeah, man.
Good, it
should.
You
know, doing the whole Demon Souls collab was just ridiculous.
Now you're doing another one, which is great. I can't get enough of this.
I know, it reminds me of like that one time when both of us were really tired, we were going through and just failing in the, me more so than anybody, we were failing in the final area, like the bullet area.
Yeah.
And fucking we gave the controller to Ayn and she just wrecked shit. God, it was so hilarious.
I think old King Alant.
Yeah, dude, she just mutilated it. Like, I think Franz died. We're like, Ayn, you gotta do it. She just goes in there and starts spamming R1 and just wrecks his ass.
Well, because she staggered him a bunch. Because you guys were using the greatsword, I think. Or no, you were using the DBS.
No, we were using the... Yeah, DBS.
Yeah, no, that was classic. Man, pure classic.
Don't start saying greatsword, though, because now I'm gonna want to do a strength build, so stop. And you have to get me away from strength builds. Save me from the strength build.
I might have a hilt list somewhere that I can give you if you want.
Dude, I'm just not a big Katana fan. I don't know why.
FromSoft is, right, Eli?
Yeah, they love them some damn Katana.
Fucking Katanas. Hold it over.
What is a Katana doing in, like, this thick European game? Just like, guys, remember Japan?
Distant land.
Yeah, this spooky, mystical weapon.
That's what it is. Like, the descriptions of all the Katana, that's what they say. This is a weapon from a distant land. It's made with superior craftsmanship to the Western weapons because they're all uneducated plebs. Our swords are better.
Even though they broke all the time and they were completely ineffective. Well, they weren't ineffective, but...
Against people that didn't wear armor in the first place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, the European broadsword.
You're cutting up is meat.
Exactly, yeah. The European broadsword and a knight in full armor would have destroyed a samurai. Like, that's just all there is to it. Or, like, anybody that wielded a katana. I mean, it just would have been a shit show.
Alright, got that.
How do you fight a walking fucking suit of armor with this big-ass heavy sword that they're just laying into you?
With a gun.
Yeah, you don't.
Thanks, technology.
With a gun? Oh, I thought you meant like they had guns. I was like, dude, the blunderbuss wasn't for like 300 years after that.
Samurai eventually started using guns themselves. They had the Tanegashima firearms, the rifle. And after that, it was just, you know, woohoo, yeah, we wear the samurai armor and we wear the Hatajirushi, the flags on our backs. But no, we use guns because we're pansies.
But no, we use guns. It's no big deal.
We think of stuff like blunderbusses. cannons and stuff like that are just really
Chinese hand cannons.
Yeah, or Willie, in Willie's case, muskets for those World War One.
yeah, he doesn't. Poor Willie doesn't know what era technology takes place in. But there were things firearms. Called there were things called ingans, which is where we get the word for gun. And they were basically just little handheld devices that ignited powder, and that's all they did. And they usually blew up in your hand.
Yep.
So those were around for a very long time, actually, except that no one used them because no one wanted to have their hand blown.
Small wonder they didn't catch on.
Where's your sign supposed to be, anyways?
Right after you walk in, there is going to be a long hallway right past the Archstone. My sign will be on the right side of the hallway just before the steps leading down.
Okay, so it's you're not... Oh, okay, I see it. All right.
Oh, you see it already?
Yeah.
Wow.
1,651 multiplayer sessions.
Like I said, I've played this game quite a bit.
Uh-oh, did we lose the call? Oh, okay.
No, I'm here.
No, that part where you said bit cut out for me, and I was like, oh, shit.
Oh, probably just the stream. I mean, Skype.
Oh, I'm positive it was just Skype.
How long you can stay connected to me.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting, isn't it?
It's going to be real bad if it turns out, oh, just my connection's so bad that no one can actually be summoned. Which happened.
We're gonna try our best, Eli. We're going to try our best.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see how this plays out.
Like, I'll summon someone in dark, and then it'll immediately say they return to the world. And that was
Oh, no, this is working.
Oh, there you go.
All right,
look at it this way, guys. I'm pretty sure most people are listening to the commentary, unless the game.
I suspect that as well. All right, so Eli, I heard you wanted to be a mage.
Oh, God, he's going to do that thing.
Oh, for God's sake.
Did he give you a frilly hat?
Sort of.
He gave me the dumb hit.
And Eli, I heard that I heard that you like trolling.
Oh my God!
So you might like that. Let's see.
Should I draw? It's the rapping at least makes sense in Demon's Souls, but it's really ludicrous.
Yeah, it's worse in Demon's Souls than it was in any of the games before that. I don't know if you're actually going to use any of these, Eli, but you can have them just in case.
I think I'm going to go for Yuria's set this time. I don't remember when you can get it, though.
Yuria's set? You get three pieces of it right in Balataria, hanging from those chains.
Oh, right. Ah, dang.
Yeah. Here, Eli, I'll give you a real piece of headgear if you want the real headgear. Oh, and actually, this and this.
You know, I'm going to be weighed down with so much equipment.
This stuff actually doesn't weigh that much.
Time to terp up for what and go fight Phalanx.
All right, awesome. Excellent.
Terp up for what? I hope he's in the stream, because that's like my favorite name of any of the Twitch followers. Easily.
Ooh, turp up for what?
Yeah, it's just something so funny, like, seeing... Wow, I just got obliterated. I mean, I didn't die, but, like, I was just getting beaten around like an idiot.
While you're doing that, Eli, let's go kill that dragon.
Hold on for a second.
Sure.
I'm trying to see if I can make the... Oh, what was the... I don't know if I can use this one either. Curse my weakness.
Oh, that's fine.
You may have noticed that the throwing animation is just absolutely terrible in Demon's Souls.
Yeah, they are. Yeah, no, those things don't mess around, Eli. They're no joke.
Yeah, I shot sword. I was farming the shit out of these guys earlier.
These things?
My other bit. Yeah, because they drop all those shards.
Yeah, they drop upgrades, which is really nice. They give you a way to get those this early in the game.
Oh, look, guys, farming. That's not mandatory. How about that shit?
Oh, yeah, how about that shit?
Wow, it's almost like if you want to better your fucking character, you can grind a little bit. But nah, let's take that part out.
Yeah, of course. So, Eli, come on over here. I think you might, Oh, he's not here, but... Yeah, Ostrava is over here if you...
Oh, sweet Jesus.
Yeah. He's not here now because you must have just let him rot. But this is where he appears on the other side of that gate.
I knew that. I saw that. It's like, yeah, if he was not dead, not a corpse, he might be dead.
Yeah, he might. He might. All right, so this little section, if you got to the Tower Knight, I assume you figured out how to get past this.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
I definitely got tired of this asshole, though.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm going to get rid of him for you. We're going to
I'm going to let him do a pass.
Yeah.
Because I know that...
All right, gentlemen, I am officially done with the phalanx.
Awesome. So, Nick, you can come put your sign down inside the first tower on the Dragon Bridge.
Yeah, let me go talk to Caillou, and then I'll come do that.
Okay. Caillou.
So how are you going to get rid of him?
Oh, you'll see. I think you'll like this.
Eli, you gotta remember, you're talking to the king of troll here, so I'm sure he's got something crazy.
Oh, I do. Remember that video I sent you last night, Eli?
No.
The monumental awaits the above.
Just no.
Oh. Well.
So, look at the chat, and just look at what the discussion, like, over European weaponry versus Japanese weaponry, look at what happened. Like, it is a knockdown, drag-out brawl.
I love starting that shit.
Dude, yeah, it's just nuts.
I don't
nuts.
Even care if people get mad about it. People start...
I don't know. I like watching people discuss it, though.
I'm like, yes. Yes.
It looks like a that. Me!
It looks like a reasonable discussion, so I'm okay
dance
with it.
Dance my puppets, dance!
Dance my puppets now.
Using,
I love
God's wrath over and over again as he passes.
This is the way to do it.
Oh, man.
I love hunting me some dragons.
This has been very fun, guys. I appreciate both of you coming along. It's always good to hang out with friends and play some Souls.
It's no problem. I enjoy it. Hanging out with you guys is the best.
I'm sorry. I can't hear you over fucking Caillou over here. Tell me bullshit. God.
Marks I heard? Thought I heard quote marks around best.
Yeah. Over 4,000 hours in Demon's Souls ever since 2009. Like, this game still punishes me for thinking, oh yeah, I'm super MLG pro. I can just speedrun this area. And then an enemy that I forgot was there just jumps out of the shadows and kills me in one hit.
Oh, of course. Every fucking time. Oh, I do love it though, man.
But that's
I love
like,
these games.
The Souls games are the gift that keeps on giving. No joke whatsoever. They really are.
I love the fact that they're so replayable. Both
yeah.
Bloodborne.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, apart from Bloodborne. Hopefully that expansion will add some content to the game that will actually improve replayability, because I have major problems about that game's lack of replayability.
You know, that clinic skip was a godsend.
Yeah, and
it really was.
Attach it.
Yeah, I loved the clinic skip.
Because
it was awesome.
It opens up, like, I could immediately go for certain weapons, finally. Whereas if you have to do it normally, it's like, well, no, you have to do this very specific series of things.
Mm. Yeah, Eli, I'm right there with you, dude. I think actually Franz and I were talking about that. Why did I just do that? I think we were talking about that the other day, about how, like, I wish they had kept the clinic skip, because it basically added in that kind of, like, Dark Souls flair. You know, like the Berg skip, where you can jump down to Capra. Mm. Yeah, that kind of, like, that, like, feeling of, well, I can just skip all this shit and go get my, you know, key to the depths, and or key to Blighttown and all this other crap and blah, 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 but... Yeah, I was a bit bummed when they did patch that, like, deliberately and very quickly, too.
I'm surprised that they went out of their way to patch it, because they've never, ever patched a skip before.
Yeah, it was a bit disappointing, but I mean, it's a bug. I mean, I get it, but
I
don't know.
I wonder if it has to do with the fact that the clinic skip was found as early in the game's life as it was, because things like the archive skip in Dark Souls 1, by the time anyone figured that out, the game was well past its prime and no longer being patched.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what it was. It was because the game is designed in such a way that if you do a skip like that, it changes the kind of day-night system, whatever you want to call it. It actually breaks some elements of the game.
Yeah, I guess.
So they kind
of does.
But I think also it might have had to do with the fact that Sony was so butthurt when somebody jumped over one of the fences in Central Yharnam during the network test and got to the Father Gascoigne fight and saw all of the incomplete environmental... textures and zones, and they were really mad about that, to the extent that they went out of their way to DMCA a bunch of those videos.
Holy shit. Well, I mean, it's it is a lot of negative publicity if you get to see an unfinished game, because people start judging it based off that. And I mean, I understand like the reluctance for people to see that, but there's also no need to be like, they should be like, well, you saw it, just keep in mind that this content is, you know, in development. So
yeah, no,
this is not
I don't,
a final product.
I don't know why they get so bent out of shape over that when obviously the game's not done. What do you expect from it? And Nick, is it just me, or did you actually get a weapon drop from that Blue Eye Knight, or was that a throwing dagger?
No way, dude. There's no way that dropped.
Phalanx is dead, by the way.
Wow, Eli, you really did speed run the area.
He mowed it down, dude. If I hadn't been an idiot, we might have been there by now.
And I didn't do anything for the dragons.
Well, that's okay. I think we might have a way of dealing with that, actually.
Do I not have any more? God damn it, I don't have any more crescent. I hate when I run out of crescent grass.
Well, at least you can carry 99 crescent grass, and 99 half moon grass, and 99 full moon grass, and 99 late moon grass, and 99 dark moon grass.
So what you're saying is I can carry some grass.
Carry 600.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if I actually... Do I care about the Ring of Great Strength? I feel like I don't with this playthrough.
Well, if you're going to go Dex, you're going to be a light character anyway. Eli, what?
Yeah,
I said I have to go talk to the Monumental, apparently, before
You can just mash through all that, though, Eli. You've seen it already.
Hey, go talk to the little bald kid with the candles. Go talk to fucking Caillou up there.
Caillou? God. Eli, when you're done down there, stay in body form and head to the Phalanx Archstone. I'll put my sign down.
Oh, that's right. We have to stay in that, don't we?
Yeah, in body form. But that's fine.
Do you have to be in body form in order for someone to, in order for you to invade someone?
You can't be in body form.
I know it has your health already.
Yeah, you have to be in soul form.
You have to be in soul form to invade in this game, and you have to be in body form to be invaded.
Okay.
But I'm going to, once you come and meet up with me, Eli, I'm going to give you a few of the item that lets you get back to body form.
Ah, the Stone of Ephemeral Eyes. Yep. Dude, this is bringing back memories, Franz, like big time.
Is it?
Yeah, man.
Good, it
should. You know, doing the whole Demon Souls collab was just ridiculous.
And now you're doing another one, which is great. I can't get enough of this.
I know. It just reminds me of like that one time when both of us were really tired. We were going through and just failing in the me more so than anybody. We were failing in the final area, like the Boletaria.
Yeah.
And fucking, we gave the controller to Ayn and she just wrecked shit. God, it was so hilarious.
I think old King Alant.
Yeah, dude, she just mutilated it. Like, I think Franz died. We're like, Ayn, you gotta do it. She just goes in there and starts spamming R1 and just wrecks his ass.
Well, because she staggered him a bunch, because you guys were using the greatsword, I think. Or no, you were using the DBS.
No, we were using the... Yeah, DBS.
Yeah, no, that was classic. Man, pure classic.
Don't start saying greatsword, though, because now I'm gonna want to do a strength build, so stop. And you have to get me away from strength build. Save me from the strength build.
I might have a hilt list somewhere that I can give you if you want.
Dude, I'm just not a big Katana fan. I don't know why.
FromSoft is, right, Eli?
Yeah, they love them some damn Katana.
Fucking Katanas. Fold it over.
What is a Katana doing in, like, this thick European game? Just like, guys, remember Japan?
Distant land.
Yeah, this spooky, mystical weapon.
It is. Like, the descriptions of all the Katana, that's what they say. This is a weapon from a distant land. It's made with superior craftsmanship to the Western weapons because they're all uneducated plebs. Our swords are better.
Even though they broke all the time and they were completely ineffective. Well, they weren't ineffective, but...
against people that didn't wear armor in the first place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, the European broadsword.
You're cutting up is meat.
Exactly, yeah. The European broadsword and a knight in full armor would have destroyed a samurai. Like, that's just all there is to it. Or, like, anybody that wielded a...
You run out of resources. Like, I don't have enough to heal or something. Then you'll do it, but...
Well, yeah, and if you have no souls or only a small amount of souls and you just need to get out quickly...
Get your ass
here, that's true.
Lazy, coward-ass dragon.
That's like my least favorite part of this zone, having to go through and grab that, because, you know, I say this, that inadvertently I fail every time, and I don't think I've failed on camera yet, which means I just jinxed the shit out of myself.
Oh yeah, you're going down now, Nick.
I'm dead, it's over, like, that's it.
Come on, you fat idiot.
Rip in peace. How did I miss that every fucking time?
There we go.
Is the dragon working now, Eli?
Yes, the big dumb moron.
What's the item down there by the exploding barrels? I can't remember.
Where, Nick? In the stairwell?
With, like, all the draglings.
It's some grass, I think.
Oh. I guess we'll get it.
If you mean the one in the hallway, it's the Kling Ring, after you pull the lever to open the gate.
No, not the one in the hallway. Whatever the fuck it's called. It's a bunch of exploding barrels, lots of draglings. It's in, like, an open air. It's kind of off to the side where the blue-eye knight with the claymore is.
Oh, yeah, I think it's just some grass. It's nothing important, I remember that much.
Well, we've gone through it now, so feck it.
Now I'm having the opposite problem. You won't go away.
when it rains, it pours, huh? Feast or famine.
Get out of here, you big dumb moron.
What you've got to do, Eli, is wait right until he starts roasting the bridge. And when he starts roasting the bridge, run back over and grab all his stuff.
Well, I'm not going to do that yet. I'm just trying to rush through.
It's actually the tail slam that kills me the most, because I'm just terrible at the timing.
Oh, from the
reason.
Blue dragon, you mean? When you're
yeah, that's what kills me. It's not the other shit. Like, I always just am like, do.
Well, you the trick, Nick, is that you've got to bait the tail slam and then run in and grab stuff afterward.
Oh, I know the trick. I'm just a failure at it. Trust me, man. I know the mechanic. Well, I'm just bad.
It helps to be able to acknowledge your shortcomings.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not gonna pretend like the best Souls player ever. There are tons of people out there better than me.
Well, not these me anymore, guys. Apparently.
I keep trying to use a jump attack with these spear guys. And it's like, yeah, there isn't one.
Nope. Yeah, I know, right?
Oh, plague, a fellow jump attack lover.
It's so useful.
Hey, people are. It's so good. I love the jump attack. Some people are just all anti-jump attack.
Oh, it's unbelievable. Like, the crazy thing about the jump attack is it's even better in Bloodborne because they went back to a system of no poise, just super armor. And jump attacks for really heavy weapons like the Kirkhammer are basically instant super armor break on nearly any enemy. There are bosses in the dungeons in particular, like the Keeper of the Old Lords, which is basically a Dark Wraith with a katana, which... if you use the jump attack on them as they're approaching you from outside their range, their AI literally does not know what to do and cannot handle it, and you can just spam jump attacks the whole battle and there's nothing they can do.
Oh, man. What was that one fight in Dark Souls 2 that people were speculating was like the Chosen Undead Reborn? Was that the... God, what the hell fight was that?
What?
It's the big white... The big white and black creature that was in the Abyss.
Oh, the Dark Lurker.
Yeah, Dark Lurker. Oh, it's totally Chosen Undead Reborn. I'm like, dear Jesus.
No, shut up.
Like that. I'm like, we are literally just coming up with shit at this point.
Well, that's...
Like fanfic frenzy, baby.
Why do you think we don't make Dark Souls 2 lore videos?
Well, I tried at one point.
A lot of people treat the Souls games.
How?
Like, it's based on your personal lore, and they take that to mean that just make up shit. For no good reason.
I tried a while back just by presenting the facts that were available in the game, and like I ultimately came to no conclusion. I was like, yeah, just, you know, here you go. Yeah. Like those are some other videos that I'm either debating on just completely taking down or just putting a big ass disclaimer that was like, these videos were made when I thought there was lore to this game. Pro tip, there's not.
Well, the last time when I described my approach to evaluating the Soul series lore to you, Eli, you what was it you said? Oh, Mr. Scientist.
I was trying to explain something, I can't remember what, and I was offering up like several explanations of what things could potentially be, and you said something like, well, I only take what information the game gives me. And I was like, oh, excuse me, Mr. Soul Scientist.
Right,
only
right.
Going by the facts.
Oh my god.
I think that was when we were talking about the effigy shield in Dark Souls 1, and we were kind of batting back and forth how, well, I was going over the explicit evidence that was provided through item descriptions and dialogue, and you were talking about some more abstract theories that involved kind of extrapolating stuff that was in the game based on conjecture, and you really let me have it over that.
I love the word extrapolate.
To be fair to myself, I was not making shit up so much as I was saying, well, here's the information that we have, which could potentially mean these things.
Oh, no, I know. That's why I described it the way I did, rather than just saying you were making shit up. Like, you were legitimately extrapolating it from fairly credible sources. But, like, it was just, you know, where that discussion went was amusing to me.
Oh, Franz, I died at the dragon, by the way.
I saw that,
I told you.
I told you to wait and bait out the tail attack, man. You didn't wait.
Bro, I did bait it. I didn't dodge at the right time.
You waited for it and you rolled face first into it, Nick.
Bro, you can roll into stuff just because I mistimed it. You could roll whatever direction you want in the
You
can
roll into stuff, but some of it'll kill you. You could roll into those fires right there if you want.
Dude, I'll roll into it. Just watch me. You don't control my
He'll
life.
Do it just to spite me. He'll now jump into one of these fires just to spite me.
I have not used this flame toss yet.
It's pretty damn good.
Yeah,
I've been cheesing the shit out of the soul arrow.
He was like, shit, you better get this.
Yeah.
You better get this shit, you dumb. Oh my god, I should have opened up the damn shortcut before I did all this garbage.
I was gonna say, you didn't open up the shortcut first.
No, I let the dragon clear the damn bridge, and then I was like, yeah, I've got it. Dude, every time I'm lazy in the Souls series, dude, this game just bites me in the fucking ass.
But that's the beauty of the Souls games.
I'm with you, man. I get it.
Like, even after having played these Demon Souls specifically, I've got, at this point, probably over 4,000 hours. In fact, unequivocally over...
Was that a glitch in the audio, or was that a belch?
You can't even tell.
Like, I couldn't actually tell if it was a glitch. Or a belch. Dude, oh god. After all that Dark Souls and then just coming straight to demons, I feel like I've run the gamut lately, dude. Because, like, I was doing, like, all this Bloodborne, then did some Witcher, and then fucking back to Dark Souls, now I'm in Demon Souls. I don't even know what I'm doing anymore.
You can't escape it. Whenever you think you're out, the Souls series sucks you back in.
No, dude, demons just, like, I love the vibe I get. Like, I just love the music in demons, and... Well, it's got
like
a great aesthetic to it.
Stuff too. Like, I'm just coming into demons. I'm coming into demons.
I see what you did.
Things just like the FX and stuff like that has its own distinct feel.
It does, yeah.
Yeah.
Like, I could just listen to the character create music forever, too.
The sound design for this game was excellent. The Foley was pretty damn solid, and especially the soundtrack. Shunsuke Kida is the one who did the soundtrack for this game.
Yeah, he's awesome.
Yeah, he's very, very talented guy.
I thought they'd bring him back for Bloodborne, but I was a bit disappointed to see that they didn't.
They didn't, but what was his name? Ryan Amon, whom they got for Bloodborne. He did a damn good job, too.
He really did do a great job. I'm just saying, I'm surprised, since it's such a spiritual successor to Demons, they weren't like, oh, let's just get the same fucking guy. But Sakuraba did very well with Dark Souls 2. Like, it actually had some great tracks.
And he did Dark Souls 1's OST as well, didn't he, Sakuraba?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He did well with Dark Souls 2 as well. So, I mean, relative, I guess.
It was really strange to me when I first heard that Motoi Sakuraba had done the soundtrack for Dark Souls 1 and 2, because I will never be able to picture his music as anything other than like the soundtracks from Valkyrie Profile and Star Ocean that are really, really synthesizer heavy and just have a completely different sound than the Souls. Like, Souls is very orchestral, whereas Valkyrie Profile and Star Ocean are synthesized to the max, and like, those were fantastic soundtracks as well. They really capitalized on the synthesized aspects of that, but completely, vastly different styles from the same guy. It's amazing what Sakuraba is capable of in terms of variety.
Well, Shimamoto is the exact same way. Like, I mean, even like Legend of Mana and Kingdom Hearts, while they do share... let me ban this.
Those are a lot closer, though. Like... Yoko Shimamoto's music... The Kingdom Hearts soundtrack is a lot more similar, I think, to the Legend of Mana soundtrack than the old Enix games were to Souls, you know?
Sorry, I got distracted. I had to ban somebody in chat. So I know I just said something about Shimamoto and like how even Legend of Mana and Kingdom Hearts, while sounding similar, sound totally different, like in terms of their presentation. And I guess you had a response to that, and I totally missed it. Sorry.
Oh, it was just that those are a lot more similar to each other than the Star Ocean or Valkyrie Profile games and Souls soundtracks. And Nick, did you say you were going to use a rapier?
Yeah, I am. I guess I will. Yeah.
Okay.
Dude, oh god, it feels so good to play like a fast character after doing so much Bacon Man tonight. Like it's just like.
Whenever we were talking about demons, I knew it was like, he's gonna love coming back to this.
Oh my god, I feel so much speedier. I'm just like, oh, thank god.
I don't know if it's just the Bacon Man build that did that, but is it just me, or do the rest of you feel this way as well, that playing the later Souls games just makes coming back to demons that much more satisfying?
It does. There's a lot that they got right. I mean, like, Dark Souls is still my favorite, but I mean, that doesn't mean by any stretch that I don't like the other ones. Well, Dark Souls 2, but we've beaten that to death tonight, so I'm just gonna shut up about it.
Okay.
Like, I can't say any more about Dark. I mean, I could, but I don't think anybody wants to hear it. By the way, we are one of three Demon Souls streams, and I feel real bad because the other two have like one viewer.
Well,
like I see that, and like I understand, like, you know, just starting out a channel, and it can be really, really hard, and I want to like support, but the problem is like so many people are doing this now. And they just don't put any effort in. You go in there and you're just like, oh my god, what's happening here?
Sitting there playing, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, they've got like this like awful green screen face cam and their mic sounds like it was in a dumpster and like...
It was... They're recording in a dumpster, they just live there.
But that's not like... That has nothing to do with the other streamers, I haven't even seen them, but... I can understand why people sometimes are reluctant to try new stuff.
Yeah, and we're kind of lucky in some ways that Peeve isn't streaming Demon Souls tonight, because if he was, we'd be the second stream of Demon Souls.
We'd be just dead last. Like, we just can't compete with the power that is Peeve's stream.
Well, I mean, whenever he streams Demon Souls, he ends up with like about 1,000 viewers or more. Like the time that I ended up as his old monk boss and we just had a fist fight, that was the best. But that time I think he had around 1,600 people.
He's a great player, dude. He deserves it. Like,
well, he has his moments. I think during that entire fight, I parried him 3 or 4 times, and I actually managed to parry his headbutt, which I didn't even know was possible.
I didn't know. Oh, yeah, you were telling me about that, and I think in our Demon Souls playthrough, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we finally were able to pick it back up.
Yeah,
but...
Peeve's awesome. It's really a shame he couldn't make it tonight. But, I mean, especially considering that now here we are playing Demon Souls, but he had to go out and buy a computer desk.
It's been quite a while since I've seen any Peeve stuff. I know I have in the past, but it's been a while.
Well, he doesn't upload to YouTube very often. He almost exclusively streams on Twitch these days, and what he does upload to YouTube tends to be stream highlights.
Now I've got to remember how... the Blue Knight fog door. I was trying to remember how I even got there in the first place.
Oh, yep.
How do I do...
Yeah, that fog door past the Blue Eye Knight just leads to everything.
I mean,
it's
a good thing we're starting new characters, because there's no way that... I mean, if we're going to a completely new area, I guess, but being able to run through this area now that I know it fairly well is much better.
It's much amazing better. How much difference that makes, isn't it?
Very much. Also, the first time I went through this thing, I was completely lost.
Just to address the chat real quick, I'm going to do my best to keep track of everything. Like, what am I doing? I literally just rolled into the Red Eye Knight and just got obliterated. What am I doing? Like, this is what happens when you play Souls for like 8 hours straight. But I just wanted to clarify earlier what I meant when I was talking about the other things. That wasn't like saying anybody was bad. I'm just saying like I understand people's reluctancy to try new things, because sometimes, like, you know, you just run into so much bad that you're just like, I just can't give anything else a shot. And like, and I know that feeling, like, especially with like music and stuff lately. I've just been, I'm kind of like that now too, where I'm just like, it's an artist in this genre, it's gonna suck. Like, I'm just like giving up, I'm like, fuck.
I find myself just listening to video game music all the time now. I just can't listen to anything else, because...
It's pretty easy to do, man. There's a lot of great stuff out there.
Yeah.
Especially as you get older, it can be music or movies or whatever. You do kind of get into this rut of, I know this is good, and I do not have the energy to fight all this new stuff, just to try to figure out what, you know, I... actually can tolerate.
So yeah, definitely.
The same thing over and over again.
Absolutely. Yeah, yes.
Yeah, the getting old rut.
We're all there, aren't we? We all know how that... Well, not you, Nick. You're young.
Oh my god. Stop it. You do this every time. You're like, you're so much younger. I'm like, you're like 2 years older than me.
Does Strava leave unless you go down there and visit him?
Well, what happens is that what you're meant to do, and this is kind of dumb in some ways, but... When you beat Phalanx and then advance to the next area on the way to the Tower Knight, Ostrava will move to that area to a spot where he's actually safe.
Well, I was just wondering if I could run past this, although I kind of would like to get the thief's ring.
Well, if you run past it without talking to Ostrava, then he'll just stay there and never move forward.
Good, because he got his dumbass killed on my other build.
Right.
How did he get killed, dude?
This was a great story. Well, I laughed at this.
He didn't really kill himself so much as I brutally murdered him.
Why?
You didn't murder
because him. I rescued him.
I thought you said
I rescued him in like true Dark Souls fashion. I thought, ah, I got that part done, and I rezoned because I was trying to get some of the shit from under the dragons. Right.
Right. Right.
And, I didn't realize that he was still there, and in addition to still being there, since you talk to him once, he just drops down and kills all the enemies and keeps going about his business like he would if he was routing after you clear the area for him.
He wanders around, yeah.
And I was strolling through, and then I looked down and saw a health bar dropping. I was like, oh, fuck, so drop up. So I had to run down there, and I saw he had like 10 health left or something. And I turned a corner, and I saw like one guy dropping to his knees like, oh, shit. So I just swung, and it turned out he had just got through killing an enemy, and I beheaded him. With one swift motion.
Oh, poor Ostrava. You murdered him in cold blood.
You know what? That freaking idiot had it coming. I was sick of his whining.
I was sick of his whining.
Help! Help! I got myself trapped in a bunch of demons for no good reason. Help!
Solero is so broken early on.
All the magic and demons. Granted, when they added the dark magic in Dark Souls 1, that was unequivocally more broken. But, like, Firestorm in hyper mode in Demon Souls, it didn't get much more broken than that until dark magic in Dark Souls 1.
So, Plague, how did you end up handling your Red Eye Knight problem?
I have actually never been hit by him before, so I don't know how strong he is. But
Yeah, I was going to say, do you just... Because I ran back, like, I wait, and I'll keep the Blue Eye Knight up and the Red Eye Knight, and I'll just kite them both back and just let them fly off the edge.
It does take quite a while to farm him using that method, I noticed.
It does, yeah. But, I mean, the thing that's nice, I guess, about having soul arrows, you could just nail the Blue Eye Knight, and that one-shots him, and then you could just kite the other dude back and just let him fall off.
I just parry the Blue Eyes, just because he's so fucking easy. He's basically...
He is.
Try that with the Red Eye Knight, see how long it lasts.
Well,
with that damn spear, dude. And he just...
I knew from Dark Souls experience that parrying spears is no joke.
Oh yeah, nope, not at all. And it's worse unbeatable. With the Red Eye Knights in particular because they don't follow the player model animations. They have their own rig and their own attacks. And their forward thrusting spear attack that looks like it should hit you all of once will actually hit 7 or 8 times for enormous damage each hit. And it's instant death. And it'll stun lock the shit out of you so you can't get away from it.
Sort of like the pike or the stock running attack.
Yeah, very similar. Except like 4 of those in one attack.
Oh, the climbing in Demon Souls is so silly.
Yeah.
I really like that though. I mean, not really a working system exactly. But I like being able to jump over shit.
Yeah.
Ostrava, you should totally help me fight these guys. So I'll just backstab you off.
Just like everybody else does.
I mean, I love Ostrava, but I'm not past doing that to him.
He's not, like, completely capable. He's not like he's just some weakling or something, exactly.
No, but he is a moron.
Yeah.
Well, he's a pampered son. He's a pampered son with, like, fancy armor.
Fair enough. Yeah, I guess...
Release the balls.
I'd give an arm just for the buttons off his shirt.
He really is cool, though. Like, I like Ostrava. It's a tragic ending for him too.
Yeah.
It's like, well, that's sad.
Wouldn't have it any other way. Miyazaki doesn't like happy endings because fuck that, it's Japan.
No, there he likes happy endings. Remember he's got the slug ending.
What?
Oh, chosen slug undead.
Are you cold?
Come on, people.
Oh right, that's
oh good ending. Hunter slug, you're my favorite chosen undead. This soul binds you to the Nexus, Great One. Oh, man. Oh, the Scimitar. Scimitar.
I have to say, I think that the obligatory use all souls to warp back to X area makes the most sense in Demon Souls because it's a leg shackle.
Yeah, that's true.
And when they say, it binds you to the Nexus, they mean that literally, like you're shackled to the Nexus.
Well, the dark sign binds you to undeath, I mean.
Because it's like, you know, if I'm there, I'm going to try. I think it's...
Void, I'm not forgetting about Chad, I'm sorry.
I think it's more made if...
And we are back.
Hello again, everyone.
Hello.
Hi, guys. It's been a long time. Oh, Eli and Franz, you're here.
Yes, we are.
How'd you guys get back here so fast?
You can't get rid of us that easily.
Oh, God. Oh, man. So here we are with Salmon Souls, as per requested.
Salmon Souls. Really?
Well, the...
Salmon.
The box art's kind of a salmon-y color, so salmon souls, why not?
Are we
kind of thing.
Really, are we at that part of the night now?
We literally just started, so well, I mean, I guess so.
We just started after something like 8.5 hours of bacon, man, though. Let's date this right now. This is about half an hour on the heels of the end of the Bacon Man stream.
God, it is, man. That's the crazy part.
It is.
How did we do, dude? Honestly, like it's kind of a blur. Like looking back at it now, like I barely even remember all of it.
Well, you'll remember soon enough.
Yeah, when I go through to edit it, which thankfully I don't have to do much. I just need to cut it and then export. God. So I'm thinking. I know Eli's thinking a Dex build, right?
Kind of.
I think that's kind of what I'm going for, too. So, either like Dex, magic-y kind of thing, I guess.
My first character's name is Plague. This one's name will also be Plague.
Plague again.
Awesome. Aren't you glad you only have 4 slots for characters in this game?
Oh, look, Franz, it says Johannes, a Finnish spy, is back.
Oh, God. Well, I'm just glad that there are only 4 character slots, because that way we won't get all 10 Plagues.
Oh man, what's the most weeaboo name I could come up with for this character?
Something incorrectly written in Romanji.
Oh, like God. Okay, we'll wait on chat because I'm sure chat will have some wonderful weeaboo names for us.
You can completely skip the tutorial. I didn't know that.
Once you've done it once on one character, you can. Yes.
This starts. You died.
Yep.
That's pretty awesome, dude. I love Demon Souls, man.
I do too. Okay.
So I just need to rush through this first area and beat Phalanx, I guess.
Yeah, you can just speed run it. And I mean, if you want to go lure the Red Eye Knight off the battlements a couple of times for some souls for firebombs, that works too.
Okay, I just need to remember how to get there. I need to unlock. I need to get to the Dragon Bridge, right?
Yeah, and to get there, head up to the top of the steps and turn left.
Oh God, so many names. Jesus Christ. Let's see, we've got Franzu Senpai, and just name her Gatsu because literally only weebs stand by that version of his name.
Well,
oh my God.
It's hard to argue with that.
To answer the question of which Souls Blood game is the longest overall, not counting cheap skips. Spunk, it really depends on what you make it, man. Any Souls game can be the longest one. It depends on how much effort you're willing to put it. Suzuki Hayabusa. Jesus Christ, that one's perfect.
Oh, God. I don't know if you can fit that, though.
I don't think I could, but Suzuki will definitely be one. That is definitely a weeb.
Oh, you're still in character creation?
Yeah, I'm still...
Okay, good. See, it's gonna be a little bit of time.
Oh, yeah.
Well, we were joking about this, that, like, you might be the one that ended up in character creation the longest. Look, my ass is still... 10 million feet behind.
I'm probably just going to delete this character later, just because I need to have everything perfect.
I am completely with you on that, Eli.
This kind of looks like God. Me, though. A more rugged, handsome version of me.
Why is she fucking... Why are her eyes like that? Oh, God.
Well, you're making a Japanese eyes. Character, no, Nick? Why are her eyes like that? You're freaking
Smoke
racist.
Weed every day.
I was complaining to Franz about this last night. How it's so hard in the Souls games to get something that has a chin. Yeah. Like, if the chin wants to
blend
directly
into
the neck.
That is absolutely true. You're definitely right. Why is that so difficult?
Face gen, that's why. Actually, I don't remember if these games even use face gen. I think face gen was what they used in Fallout, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Alright, so I'm doing royalty female. Do you contest to this, Franz?
I do not.
All right. Wait, was royalty the one with the that started with the
rapier and with soul arrow?
Okay, yeah, that's. I was making sure it started with soul arrow.
I started as a magician.
Magician,
soul arrow.
Yeah, dexterity and magic.
Oh, and okay. You're going for a mage build, Eli?
It instructed me that this would be the best way to go. As far as Mugen Monkey goes, which could be completely wrong.
Well, no, Mugen Monkey is pretty decent most of the time, so...
It's kind of hard to take that site seriously.
What, Mugen Monkey? Yeah.
Thank you, Lipton Franz the Penis, for donating.
What? Oh, God.
Lipton Franz the Penis. Like, I like how it used to be kind of, like, pseudo-clever, then it was just ridiculous. Now it's just, like, penis.
Just go like, right there. Don't cut out the middle, man. Just cut straight to the chase. So the world might
be mended. Penis butt deer spank.
So nothing like a quick deer spank to get the blood flowing.
Hell yeah.
Chosen undead, you are the blood. Chosen undead, welcome to the Nexus.
Quiet you.
That's how it works, right?
Get my ass.
All right. Stockpile Thomas, love you. You're the best. I guess we're getting straight into the game. Like, are we wasting time with anything?
Oh, I don't. I mean, wasting time is all a matter of opinion. I don't know that you're wasting time.
That's true. That's true.
Whoa.
Oh, Strunson, that was nothing, dude. We almost hit 400 earlier. Which was amazing.
Oh, you
gave me the warm jiblies. All thanks to Eli and Franz over here.
Oh,
we're
nice.
Actually one. We are
I'm
one of three streams.
Tweet later once we actually get rid of Phalanx.
Okay.
Once we start the co-op proper.
Sounds good.
That.
That.